Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to the channel. So if you're watching this video, you've probably heard me talk about something concerning digital products and physical products in the past. And in this video, I basically want to go over some of the conditions that you might want to decide or look into if you are choosing to do either a physical product or a digital product business online. Now, the both businesses I'm talking about are both online businesses. And I'm just going to give a brief explanation of what they are. The physical product business is where you sell physical products to people, you know, by finding them on the internet and delivering products physically to them. While digital products is basically selling digital products as online products. It could be ebooks, journals, you know, stuff like that, that are created on your system and delivered on the same platform that's using online methods. You can simply deliver them by just sending a link or a login detail or stuff like that. Those are the two type of products, physical products and digital products. Now, don't get me wrong, right? These two products have both their advantages and disadvantages. And some people prefer to sell physical products, while some other people prefer to sell just digital products. But what I'm going to do in this particular video is give you some of the conditions that you need to look into or have in mind if you're choosing which one to actually sell. Now, for those who are like expert level and you know, you've been in online business for a very long time, you can decide to do the two of them. I mean, there is no problem if you decide to do both physical product businesses and digital product businesses. It's very, very good and fine. You're going to make a lot of money for yourself. But the thing is, if you have more focus or if you're able to build one to a level where, you know, it's making good money for you, and good money is anywhere from like, let's say $50,000 or $100,000, and it's making good money for you, then you can diversify and move over to another one. So I'm going to talk about the five factors that you need to have in mind, and you know, just put it at the back of your mind if you're choosing which of these businesses to go for. The first one that I'm going to talk about is time. Now, you know that time is literally one of the most important things that human beings are concerned about, and it's something that ties all of us as human beings together. Now, when it comes to time, when selling a product, choosing whether you should sell a physical product or a digital product, time is very, very important, right? For physical products, you have to understand that there is a lot more time involved, right? Because there's a lot of processes that goes into selling physical products, from the product research to finding suppliers to running adverts to delivering the products to getting paid. You know, there's a lot of time that goes into it, right? So if you're someone that has a lot of time on your hands and you don't have like a lot of money, then you know, you might actually consider doing this. But let's talk about the digital product side of things, right? So for digital products, it doesn't involve as much time as physical products, because literally the main time is when you are creating that product. After the product is created, the only other thing that's going to take your time is just marketing the product, because the delivery is, you know, it's literally instant. If somebody pays right now, no matter the time of the day that they make payments, they can get access to their product. So time is, you know, it's cut very, very short in the digital product business. So that is one thing that you need to consider if you're choosing whether you want to do a physical product business or a digital product business. Time is like the first thing you need to have at the back of your mind. The second thing is the money involved, right? For physical product businesses, it involves a lot of money to get started up and actually start seeing results. Like I said, it's physical product, so there's a lot of investment that goes into it. You know, finding the product, getting the product involves money, running ads involves money, delivering the product involves money. So there's literally money at every step of the process. This is not the same for digital product business, because with a digital product business, you can literally sit down in front of your system and create a digital product without investing any money at all. And even if you decide not to even run ads as to start with, you can get a few more sales, and then when you now want to start running ads, you can just invest some bit of, you know, cash into it and start making sales. So the kind of money that you're going to need to invest in getting a digital product business off the ground is not the same amount that you need for a physical product business. Now, in one of my previous videos, I talked about one of the fastest ways that you can actually use to get, like, you know, traction for your business. It was in that Fiverr video, the video where I talked about, you know, selling on Fiverr without selling on Fiverr, where I talked about like investing in having a page and, you know, making the page look all good and you can use it to sell. That's something you want to consider. This would actually take money whether you're selling a physical product or a digital product, but all in all, physical product is going to consume more money than a digital product, especially if you are someone that hasn't done it before and you know you have to spend money learning things and, you know, going through that whole experience process. So money is higher when it comes to physical product business. The next thing is people involved, right? For physical product business, there are a lot of people, there are a lot of hands that are in the business, because, you know, from product handling to sourcing to delivery, logistics, there's a lot of handling, there's a lot of movement, and all this movement involves people. Unless you're going to be doing everything by yourself, which is not really feasible, because how are you going to be delivering the products if you're in one part of the country and have to deliver to another part of the country? You definitely need people involved with a physical product business. So there's a lot of people involved. This might not be suitable for you if you're a very introverted person, or you're someone who doesn't do well with like talking to people and all that kind of stuff. This might not favor you. Whereas for a digital product business, it can literally be just you in your bedroom or literally any part of the world, and you can literally sit down inside one room and create everything and market it and sell and make millions without even having to talk to one person. Like, be talking to someone, when I say talking to someone, I mean like talking to someone physically, right? You don't need to talk to someone, because delivering the product is literally instant. The only people you are talking to, maybe it's by text or something, is just online. You don't need to be communicating with people and finding out, you know, negotiating prices and all that kind of stuff. Everything happens in one spot and you don't have to worry about that. So if you're an introvert, probably digital product business is what would favor you at this point in time. The next point is the ease of sales. Now, this is a place where physical product business has the upper hand than digital product, because with a physical product, right, they are relatively easier to sell than digital products. With a physical product, someone can easily see what the product is, and depending on who you're selling to, the kind of audience, most people are more comfortable, you know, buying things that they can actually see. So if they see that it's a physical product, there's something that they can see, they can hold, it's something that has a function, they can actually easily go ahead to buy that. Whereas if it's a digital product, there's a lot of doubt involved, right? With digital products, people are not sure what exactly they are getting. They're not sure how they're going to get it delivered. So there's a lot of skepticism involved. Apart from that, with a digital product, you need to have an audience. And actually, if you want to see a lot of sales, the people that are really crushing it with digital products are people that have some form of audience. Now, I know everybody has an audience, right? You have your WhatsApp list, you have everything like that. But if you want to make like serious sales with a digital product, you need to have an audience built already for that kind of product, or you have to start nurturing that product. That audience, which takes a lot of time. So this is not the case with a physical product. The physical product, you can literally just create a product like without even having an audience, and once you put it out online, people that like it are just gonna buy it. You don't need to have like a big following or a huge audience to get people buying your physical product. So this is where physical products actually comes above digital products, because in here the ease of sales is very easy. People are very much drawn to things that they can see and experience, versus you just telling them that you have a product online. There's a lot of convincing. You have to be good at copywriting, good at sales, good at marketing, good at all this stuff, and have an audience if you want to really excel and go far with a digital product. And last but not the least, there is the issue of scalability and delivery, right? Scalability and delivery. Physical products have some form of issues in this area here, because for you to scale a physical product business, you literally have to be working with a very huge system, right? Even for the delivery aspect, there has to be like super good logistics in place. This doesn't apply to a digital product business, because in a digital product business, all you literally have to do is what? You literally just have to click a button and anybody has access to digital product that you've created. If they make payment at any time of the day, they can get their order at the next minute, right? Without any delay at all. And you can literally deliver to any part of the world, any part of the continent. It doesn't matter where the person is, all thanks to the power of the internet. You can deliver your digital product and have it accessed by someone at the other end of the world in just a few minutes. So when it comes to ease of delivery, digital product takes the cake here. And also for scalability, with a digital product, it might be hard at first to get, you know, traction for it, but once it gets off the ground, once you have an audience built up, or once you have people that are actually buying that product, it is a lot easier for you to scale a digital product business versus a physical product business that has a lot of logistics involved. And then there's a lot of risk also. because you don't know what might happen, if that business is actually going to fail or if it's going to succeed, and you invest a lot of money into logistics and stuff like that. Anything can literally happen in a physical product business. And there's also the issue of loss of inventory, you know, damaged goods, you know, stuff like that. There's a lot of headache, there's a lot of complexities that is involved in a physical product business, which is why some people just prefer to do something that they can manage their risk in. Now, all that being said, you're going to notice that one of the most important parts of this video, which is the ease of sales, which is where physical products shines, is one thing that most people consider the most whenever they consider a business model. And why people do this is because with a physical product business, you don't really need to show your face, right? For a digital product business, let's say I'm selling a digital product, some form of my digital product might require me to have a face in front of a camera, because people need to see something, right? They need to see something. And in this sense, because you're not selling a physical product, what they need to see is an actual human face. But with a physical product business, nobody cares who is selling the physical product, right? It could be a 10-year-old or a 20-year-old for all they care. And all they know is that they're getting the product that they were shown on that advert or that post. People don't really care about who's the face selling this particular product. That is the reason why things like dropshipping, things like e-commerce, always have a huge audience. Because like I said in my last video, a lot of people are so scared of being in front of anything that has to do with a camera or talking to a camera like this. They don't want to talk about it, right? They don't want it at all. They just want a business where they can hide behind the screen and do their thing and, you know, just have it going. What these people don't know is that with a digital product business, you can also achieve the same thing. You don't need to be in front of a camera. You don't need to show your face, even though that might help your sales, but you don't need to show your face in order to get huge sales or people actually buying from you. You could literally just be writing, right? Just writing or just doing graphics, and people will still patronize you. So you need to also keep that a lot in mind if you're deciding which of the businesses to go for. So now that you know what the pros and cons of these various businesses are, it's now left for you to make a choice. Honestly, I would advise that you don't discount having a digital product, even if you have a physical product, because of the ease of deliverability, the other factors I've listed, the fact that there's less time involved, you know, there's less money involved in creating one, there's also less people involved, you know, there's less hassles, there's less problems in delivery. I would strongly encourage you to have your own digital product. Now, probably in my next video, I'll talk about a digital product that I helped my sister create, and you know how she's making money with that digital product. If you guys want to see me talk about that product or that particular activity where she made a lot of money, all you need to do is just like this video, share the video. The story is also somewhere on my Facebook, so you can also head over to my Facebook to check it out. And I have an offer there for people who want to make a killing with digital products. I'm going to help you actually create your own digital products and start making sales for yourself. So if you can find that video on YouTube, so another video, that post actually on YouTube, sorry, what I keep saying YouTube, it's on Facebook, right? If you see it on Facebook, you can go ahead to check it out, and I will help you guys, you know, start up your own business and make some good money for yourself. So that is the video for now. If you enjoyed it, do let me know in the comments. And if there's a particular area that you want me to touch on, remember, all you have to do is just drop a comment and I'll make a video on it. It's been your boy Ken on the BC, aka King of Side Hustles, aka 9Billy, aka the Milk Company Online King. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out.